move that, this is the same motion I made last year, that Teresa Barth be appointed as mayor for the year. So Jim Bond as deputy mayor. And what I wanted to point out is it is an opportunity, and we can discuss this in more detail
that.
After goal setting, but an opportunity.
So that I could thank Deputy Mayor Houlihan for that gracious motion. I certainly appreciate her kind words, and I would look forward to serving the community. And I will, regardless of what happens tonight, I will continue to serve the community, and I look forward to having a positive year here on council, again, regardless of what happens tonight. I believe that that's what I owe you, and that's what I'll continue to do for you. So thank you.
Madam Chair, I would like to make a substitute motion. That motion would be to elect James Bond as mayor and Jerome Stocks as deputy mayor. Please allow me to explain why. It's been brought to my attention tonight and by a number of community members that there's ongoing confusion regarding the process of electing the mayor and deputy mayor in the city of Encinitas. So I've brought with me tonight our city ordinance, and I hope that after I read this, it will be clear in everyone's minds as to the procedure in which we currently select our mayor and deputy mayor. That does not mean that it cannot change into the future, but right now, please allow me to read the ordinance. On the second Tuesday of each December, the City Council shall choose one of its members as mayor and one of its members as deputy mayor. The mayor and the deputy mayor shall serve a term of 1 year or until a successor for each position is chosen. 3 affirmative votes shall be required to choose or change the mayor or deputy mayor. In addition to the powers and duties of a council member, the mayor, or in the mayor's absence, the deputy mayor shall be the presiding officer of the city council. And that's it. Unfortunately, over the years, the city council has vacillated between simply taking turns and following our own city ordinance, which clearly explains that the mayor and deputy mayor are selected by a majority vote of the council. And unfortunately, this has led to tension and animosity among council members, which is unfortunate for the council and for the public. I ran on a platform of restoring cooperation at City Hall and bringing people together.
Everyone, please, everybody, please respect everybody's right to speak and be heard. So if
Thank
you wouldn't
Madam
mind.
Chair. I believe that cooperation will begin with a strong leadership team. And I encourage my fellow council members to do what's right for the citizens of Encinitas and follow our own city ordinance, which follows a most basic democratic process. And this is the same process that got us all elected. We need to follow our own established procedures and select the best consensus-building leadership team possible to serve the citizens of Encinitas. And our citizens demand that we move past petty politics.
Hold on, everybody, please, let her finish.
And political grandstanding, ensuring Encinitas runs well into the future and is financially secure in these challenging times. So I thank you.
Second that motion.
All right. I actually have a substitute motion takes precedent, so I don't see anybody else. Can we comment on a substitute motion before we vote, or does it require an immediate vote?
Yes, you can comment on it.
Okay. I wanted to comment because I was hoping to move forward in a constructive manner. I was hoping to just say, let's bygones be bygones. I went in yesterday and I asked Mr. Bond, Councilmember Bond, my colleague, if, because of what he had said last year, if it would be acceptable to him to support a motion that I would make, the motion I made tonight. I was informed at that time that they had already decided that Jim Bond would be mayor and Kristin Gaspar or Jerome Stocks would be deputy mayor. I am sorry, we are on a bad foot, but when I hear someone talking about petty politics and political grandstanding, and I'm sorry, I would not have normally said this, but this is said by a person who before she decided to run for office, never attended a meeting. So didn't really know if there was petty politics and political grandstanding. I think in general, even if there's disagreements, that would be an unfair statement.
Sir, you had your opportunity to speak, sir. It's mine. Thank you. So with that, again, I have seconded the motion. I've made my comments. And one other thing, Ms. Houlihan, it really gets old having allegations that are unfounded, all right? If somebody made a deal, I would have known about it because I would have been one of the three. I didn't make a deal. I did not seek consensus. I did not speak with more than one of my council members. If you're saying that a deal was cut, you are wrong, and you owe this council majority an apology.
Excuse me, I have a right to my opinion, and you're saying, once again, allegations. This is the petty bickering.
Well, you have your right to an opinion and not to your facts, right? Facts are facts.
I want to point out that that baseless charges, I don't know what, yet again, another baseless charge. I do want to say, if we put this on the, I have no problem putting a directly elected mayor, and we'll discuss this probably during goal setting, I think it's fine to put a directly elected mayor option on a ballot, but I also think it's important to give folks a chance to have, as they do in many other cities very successfully, the opportunity to have the rotation so that the elected mayor doesn't become such a huge issue in a city, and let the public decide whether they want duly elected or an opportunity to have a rotating mayor according to a system based on votes.
Yes, Councilmember Gaspar made a substitute motion. Stock seconded it to appoint Bond as the mayor for 2011 and Stocks as the deputy mayor.
All right. Go ahead. Let's just do it one by one. Gaspar?
No.
All right, everybody. Everybody, the meeting is adjourned, and we'll all work together. We'll get through this.